A long time ago, I used to live in Las Vegas, and I had a neighbor. He was some drunk former military guy, and one day we were talking about nothing, and he had told me that he used to work at Area 51. And so I was like, oh yeah, you know, have you seen the aliens? What do they look like? Blah, 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 yada, yada. And he would never, ever tell me. Nothing, nothing, nothing. You couldn't pry anything out of him. But one night, we had a power outage. And, the whole neighborhood was black. You couldn't see anything. So the night sky was, like, really dark. You could see, like, a lot of the stars because there was no outside light to drown out the stars. And he was real stinking drunk. I remember this guy used to drink like a half gallon of whiskey every 3 days. So we're just talking and bullshitting, and out of nowhere he goes, hey, you see Orion's belt? And I was like, no, I don't know what the hell it looks like. And he goes, yeah, up there. He goes, you see Orion's belt? He goes, you see how you see two stars that are straight, very, very parallel to each other, and then there's a little star that's slightly adjacent and off to the, you know, left. And I said, yeah, yeah, I see it, whatever. And he goes, the bad aliens live on that adjacent star. And I looked at him and I'm like, okay, yeah, yeah, sure, whatever. And he goes, yeah, no, he goes, I'm serious. He goes, the two stars, that's where the good aliens live. The bad aliens live on that other star. And he said the good aliens look like the traditional grays that we see on magazines, on the internet, with the big head, the big eyes, they're really small and gray. He said the bad aliens are brown colored, very tall, and they smell. I don't know what the hell he was talking about, so I'm like, yeah, 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 sure. And then I'm like, because I didn't really believe in UFOs then, but I said, if there's really aliens, I said, how do their UFOs, like, how are they able to travel from that star all the way over here? Because, you know, we're dealing with, you know, rocket engines and stuff like that. And he said that the UFOs, they basically run on electricity that's created out of nothing. I think he said space. He goes, they have like a, it was really, you know, it was, he said it in a confusing way, but he said that the UFOs run on electricity that's gathered up in space, and that instead of how a rocket is driven by thrust, by a combustion engine, he says the reason how the UFOs are able to go so fast is that he said that there's an engine on a UFO that opens up a void in space, and it's almost like, he said, the UFO, it's not that it's being thrust, but it's falling into itself. I don't know. I'm not sure if I believed him, but he said it pretty matter-of-factly. And he was, super drunk, because this guy, you could not ever have told him anything of a kind. You could never tell, you know, get anything out of him. But then he just goes off and says that. So who knows? It could be real. I mean, UFOs, you know, I kind of do believe in UFOs because I kind of seen one. I'm not sure if it was real, but it was in the Mojave Desert, and there was a plane going overhead, but it was going way, way too fast to be a plane. It's almost like when you see a jet and, you know, it's going, you know, over, across the sky. It's probably doing 500 miles an hour, maybe 450. Well, this thing was going like 40 times faster than what a jet would be going up that high in the sky. So I don't know what the hell it was. And who knows? Is it true? Hell if I know. But if any government officials see this, and if this is true and I let out government secrets, please don't kill me. I don't want to die. I don't know. Maybe I should just keep my mouth shut. Really dark. You can see like a lot of the stars because there was no outside light to drown out the stars. And he was real stinking drunk. I remember this guy used to drink like a half gallon of whiskey every 3 days. So we're just talking and bullshitting, and out of nowhere he goes, hey, you see Orion's belt? And I was like, no, I don't know what the hell it looks like. And he goes, yeah, up there. He goes, you see Orion's belt? He goes, you see how you see two stars that are straight, very, very parallel to each other, and then there's a little star that's slightly adjacent and off to the, you know, left. And I said, yeah, I see it, whatever. And he goes, the bad aliens live on that adjacent star. And I looked at him and I'm like, okay, yeah, sure, whatever. And he goes, yeah, no, he goes, I'm serious. He goes, the two stars, that's where the good aliens live. The bad aliens live on that other star. And he said the good aliens look like the traditional grays that we see on, you know, in magazines on the internet with the big head, the big eyes. They're really small and gray. He said the bad aliens are brown colored, very tall, and they smell. I don't know what the hell he was talking about. So I'm like, yeah, sure. And then I'm like, because I didn't really believe in UFOs then. But he goes, I said, if there's really aliens, I said, how do their UFOs, like, how are they able to travel from that star all the way over here? Because, you know, we're dealing with, you know, rocket engines and stuff like that. And he said that the UFOs, they basically run on electricity that's created out of nothing. I think he said space. He goes, they have like a, it was really, you know, it was, he said it in a confusing way, but he said that the UFOs run on electricity that's gathered up in space, and that instead of how a rocket is driven by thrust, by a combustion engine, he says the reason how the UFOs are able to go so fast is that he said that there's an engine on a UFO that opens up a void in space, and it's almost like, he said, the UFO is not that it's being thrust, but it's falling into itself. I don't know. I'm not sure if I believed him, but he said it pretty matter-of-factly. And he was, super drunk, because this guy, you could not ever have told him anything of a kind. You could never tell, you know, get anything out of him. But then he just goes off and says that. So, who knows? It could be real. I mean, a long time ago, I used to live in Las Vegas, and I had a neighbor. He was some drunk former military guy. And one day we were talking about nothing. And he had told me that he used to work at Area 51. And so I was like, oh, yeah, you know, I haven't seen the aliens. What do they look like? Blah, 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 yada, yada. And he would never, ever tell me nothing. You couldn't pry anything out of him. But one night we had a power outage, and like the whole neighborhood was black. You couldn't see anything. So the nice guy was like,